How to resolve eye bags after PRP. I'm 41. I never had eye bags. 2 months ago, I received PRP, the Vampire Facelift. It was one half of the usual amount used. No hyaluronic acid. Little Botox on eye corners. Eye bags appeared since the PRP was performed. Is this edema? An eye was bruised and is still bluer. I read on many sites that PRP helps reducing eye bags by increasing blood flow. Why this happened? What are your suggestions? I was told to do transconjunctival blepharoplasty. However, I wish there was a gentler approach to resolve this.
Thank you for your question. You're 41 years old and you describe a scenario where 2 months prior you underwent some PRP injection around the eyes. You refer to it as the vampire facelift, but without the hyaluronic acid filler. You had some Botox, you had some bruising, some swelling, and you state that you've had under eye bags since that time, and that you've been advised to undergo a transconjunctival blepharoplasty, but you are looking for a gentler approach to dealing with the bags. And it appears that you may feel that there was a cause and effect here. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. My background training for eyes was first in ophthalmology and then advanced training of plastic surgery of the eyes, which is called oculoplastic or oculofacial plastic surgery. I've been in practice for over 20 years. I'm also a member of the Vampire Facelift Network of Physicians, and I have been a resource for the media at times for commentary about the vampire facelift procedure. I use PRP a lot in my practice. We use it for many indications, from under eye dark circles to fine lines and wrinkles to acne scars, as well as in combination with acellular matrix and other elements for non-surgical hair loss. I perform eyelid surgery pretty much every day in my practice, and I'm an expert in helping people with problems such as under eye bags, as well as complications of eyelid surgery. So it is interesting to hear about your experience. I think that without the benefit of photos, I will give you some understanding of the anatomy of the issues involved. So to begin with, platelet-rich plasma is a concentration of the cells and the growth factors needed, or healing factors needed, when there is wound healing. And so by using platelet-rich plasma in the skin, you're able to improve skin texture and quality. Having a bruise or swelling is a byproduct of just entering the skin with a needle, as well as just usually a little bit of fluid from the actual volume of the PRP or platelet-rich plasma. Sometimes there can be a little bit of swelling as a response to the stem cell or adult stem cell activity and wound healing process, which is the basis for stimulation of collagen. Now, anatomically speaking, eye bags are a manifestation of lower eyelid fat prolapse. That means the fat that's from behind the septum, or a barrier that is behind the skin and the muscle, is actually the barrier that prevents the fat from moving forward. Anatomically speaking, there are basically two issues with lower eyelid fat prolapse. One is genetic thinning of the septum, as well as increased volume of lower eyelid fat. It may be that you were dealing with some degree of this lower eyelid fat prolapse, where there was some good days and bad days, and that's from my own experience with patients who I've been I've been performing the surgery for over 20 plus years. At a certain point, there's a threshold that's reached where the fat just pushes forward, can't do anything about it. Sometimes with medical treatment, there is a correlation causation type of logical fallacy where the event can occur and then you see these fat pockets and you think that there is going to be a cause and effect. But platelet-rich plasma, simply, there's no basis to actually see a connection which can anatomically cause fat to prolapse forward. That being said, I think that if someone has recommended a transconjunctival blepharoplasty, the doctor must have observed that there is significant enough fat prolapse. Now, when you're asking about a gentler approach, well, I can tell you in our practice, when I do perform transconjunctival blepharoplasty, again, something I do pretty much every day of the week, we have developed a gentler approach overall. It's done under local anesthesia with light sedation, and it's not that different from undergoing a filler. It is still surgery, so we don't want to understate that, but in our practice, we have our own facilities in the office, and I have made the observation that there are many times patients have almost no bruising at 1 week, and one can argue that you can have actually less bruising from a transconjunctival blepharoplasty than you would with injectable filler. So the idea of surgery may be a little bit daunting to you, but understand that this scenario can also exist where it's almost like getting an injectable filler. We sometimes even combine injectable fillers with this procedure. So I think you can get some peace of mind in knowing that it's not likely that PRP caused the lower eyelid fat prolapse to occur. You can allow several months to transpire to see the degree of the persistence of this fat prolapse and get additional opinions so that you can be secure in the diagnosis and then find the right doctor to perform the more definitive procedure for you. We do use PRP in combination with transconjunctival lower eyelid blepharoplasty routinely. In fact, for lighter skin patients, it's typical for us to do transconjunctival blepharoplasty, platelet-rich plasma, and lower eyelid fractional CO2 or erbium laser. So it's a great combination to help rejuvenate the under-eye area. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.